Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurul Hasfaliana binti Muhammad Nasir. My matric number is A19A0740. I will present about introduction. At present, Islamic banking system in Malaysia has developed significantly along with long-established conventional banking. Customer from all races and religion now has embraced Islamic banking institution as one of the safe place to deposit and invest their money. Bank Simpanan Nasional has introduced a product that offer double benefit to customer, which is called CJ Simpanan Premium SSP. CJ Simpanan Premium was launched 1 June 1978 with objective to attract public interest in saving. The bank will issue a certificate for a new open account by the customer and is entitled to earn dividend. CJ Simpanan Premium is numbering certificate that can be redeemed with or without request by the customer. Every certificate should be redeemed according to the certificate without any reduction in the value of which has been deposited. CJ Simpanan Premium is available at any Bank Simpanan Nasional branch and certificate will be issued upon registration.
The Mudarabah contract regulate the CJ Simpanan Premium transaction, which is based on the profit sharing ratio between the bank and the consumer. Mudarabah is the profit sharing arrangement between the two parties, namely the owner of the capital and entrepreneur. Mutual agreement determine the proportion distribution of the profit. However, any loss carried solely by the owner of the money, in which case the entrepreneur receives no compensation for his effort. The banker is referred to as Robo Amal, whereas the entrepreneur is referred to as Mudarib. As a financing mechanism used by Islamic Bank, it is a contract in which the Islamic Bank provides all capital while the parties manage the firm. Profit is shared in a pre-agreed upon proportion, while the loss, unless caused by the carelessness or breach of contract by the Mudarib, is borne by the Islamic Bank. In terms of SSP price giving and lucky draw characteristic, the majority of the public is still unsure about its legality since they are concerned about the presence of kara and masih element. Because the agreement used in SSP is a mudarabah contract, the profit sharing ratio was clearly stated in the akad document before the investment was made. Price giving is not a category as masih. Any profit or income derived from the deposit invested should be divided evenly to both Mudarib and Robo Amal based on the predetermined ratio. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Farhamin Khairuddin. My matric number is A19B1066. So my pet is problem of validity of CJ Simpanan Premium Scheme. There are some issues that arise related to the validity of a CJ Simpanan Premium SSP scheme by BSN. Among this issue is that most customers question the halal status of SSP because they are worried if there are elements of maisir and gharar in it. Second, there was a case of fraud committed by bank staff involving charge of cheating and deceiving the purchase of a bank's SSP investment was about RM50,000 before. Third, the SSP scheme is also exposed to interest rate risk. This is because when the interest rate in the market for deposit rise above the profit rate of Islamic banking deposit, depositor can withdraw their money from Islamic bank.
Assalamualaikum and hi. Next, I will continue explaining about the problems of validity of CJ Simpanan Premium. Before that, my name is Muhammad Irfan bin Muhammad Nazli. My matric number is A20B2307. So, there's also issue raised by the public on how their involvement in the premium savings certificate is being viewed by Islamic law. The bank, BSN, that gave the gift also carried out the financing conventionally and Islamically, then the profit earned by the bank as a group may consist of conventional gains that are not Syariah compliant and Syariah compliant profit. If a gift provided by the bank to the holder of the premium savings certificate is from such a mixed benefit, then the gift is to be accepted. This is for accepting a gift from someone who has mixed property in between halal and haram is a must. Finally, the other issue is the bank also may use money borrowed from customer to conduct non-Syariah compliant banking transaction. What's the law of that? If not convinced, not reaching the level of the confidence, the money they lend will be used for illegal transaction. Hence, the law leading to somewhere between the law of makruh and must based on the strength of the zan suspicious regarding the use of the money for the illegal transaction. In the principle, the lender, customer, is not obligated to take the notice the purpose of the use for the borrowed money.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Umairah binti Shamsul. My number matric A19A1141. So today I will present a suggestion in this assignment. Okay, let's start. So today issue, which is the sijil simpanan premium BSN was show their validity, which means it acceptable as a muamalah product and encourage people to invest for the future. Which is the BSN have a change policy about sijil simpanan premium premium as meanwhile from WDR contract to the Mu'amalah contract, which is the WDR contract to the Munarabah contract. SSP was originally classed as a WDR Damanah contract because the depositor deposit money into a bank and the fund invests the money. So which is indirectly this scenario this class as a loan, which is card contract. However, the SSP contract has been extended by the BSN via the Munarabah contract. Munarabah referred to a single agreement signed by the bank and the depositor in the agreement document. If there is a profit in the use of the customer capital, it will be distributed between the bank and the client according to the profit sharing ratio that has been agreed upon in advance. That's all. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Nokamila binti Manap. My matric number is 1980427. So today, I will continue with my part, which is conclusion. In conclusion, current global trends, especially involving the rising cost of living and rising inflation, should appeal to the public to make yearly preparations for a more challenging future. Traditionally, one of the methods used as a preparatory stage is the habit of savings. In fact, this initiative should be driven by long-term investment sijil simpanan premium SSP. Products are the only saving plan available only at BSN. Also, the government has entrusted BSN to introduce the SSP schema, which allows depositors to win various prizes while still receiving dividend returns on their deposits. At the same time, SSP is a Syariah compliant saving product that uses the Mudarabah profit sharing principle.